Hey house guests, welcome to today's Big Brother Canada 5 updates and spoilers. Our house guest of the day is Katie Schnapp. Katie, thank you so much for your support. We really appreciate it. I'm at a loss for words, but seriously, thank you so much. And if you guys want to be house guests today, we're running out of days. Check out our Patreon link in the info box below. All right, so remember how the other day we were talking about Kevin having that like super insane sprinkle study chart? And then he destroyed it because Dylan found it and he didn't want to give anyone else the satisfaction of ruining it. Well, he's been rebuilding it and he has this whole like study area set up in the HOH bathroom, but he's made it so obvious that there's something there because he stacked up like all those orange, like ottoman things to try and hide it. Well, Dylan told Aika about the study setup because he still knows about it. And he showed it to Dimitri's, and Dimitri's started moving some of the sprinkles around. He didn't even use the tweezers. So he was messing up that study board, but you know what? I'm pretty sure that I saw that Kevin went back later and realized that stuff was moved around, so like, he knows. He has that shit down. So Dimitri's has been making his own study guide with some candy from the Baywatch screening, but listen, man, it's nowhere near Kevin's. Dimitri's, Aika, and Karen were all studying together. Nowhere near Kevin Martin. Kevin knows like how many times each house gets blinked during each competition. I mean, he knows everything. He's got this solid. I'm sorry, but it's gonna take a miracle for anyone to beat him in a competition like that, like a day's competition or anything like that. So yeah. Other than that, it was a pretty boring day yesterday. The feeds were in and out a ton. There was definitely some weird shit going on because the house guests weren't supposed to be in the living room. Why though? And also, you know, they would randomly, one by one, disappear for a while and just, like, completely be off the feeds. I'm thinking that they were filming something extra, either for the finale or possibly for this Baywatch thing that we're gonna see tonight. I don't know what they were doing, but I feel like they were filming some extra material. That's just what I'm thinking. But Karen was also bad-mouthing Kevin a bunch, so I mean, it was a typical day. Typical day. So today, Dylan and Dimitri's were chatting in the kitchen, and they were talking about people throwing competitions throughout the season. Obviously, Dimitri's is really against that. It really pisses him off. He doesn't have it in him to throw a comp like that. So when he sees people like Dre going all season throwing comps because they don't care and he's protecting them, that really made him angry. So Dylan was also upset with himself because he did not go as hard as he could in that last power veto competition. He's like, I could have won that. He was like, I thought Kevin would have kept the nominations the same. He got complacent. And you know, in any of these reality show competition, whatever things, like Big Brother, Survivor, anything like that, when you start to feel comfortable, that is when you're in trouble because that is when you are the most vulnerable. It's game over. So then Aika and Karen, BFF Club continues. They were doing their makeup together for like forever. And Aika was opening up about how she's really scared because she didn't expect to meet someone like Dimitri's in here. She's always been so against showmances, and she didn't want to like him, but she can't help it. And Karen's just like, oh yeah, I totally see that. And then Karen says, Kevin Martin was trying to get in her head, and he said that Dimitri's and Aika are one of the strongest couples in Big Brother history, and Karen said to him, no, they are the strongest. They're stronger than Jillian and Emmett. And I think, you know, she's got a good point there. They're definitely up there with them. But Jillian and Emmett, they were both good at competitions. This one, like, Dimitri's is really good at comps, but then Aika is really good with the social game. So, I mean, you could make the argument that they're better. I don't know. But anyway, Karen wanted to brag to Kevin that she's been working with DeMica the whole time, but she didn't because she wants Kevin to be surprised. Oh my god, Karen. Karen is really screwing herself over, okay? I mean, she would definitely go to the final two with Kevin. She would probably go to the final two with Dylan. But if she is there with Aika and Dimitri's, they're going to take each other in the final three. It's not going to happen for Karen if she's with them in the final three. So she really is screwing herself over. But anyway, Kevin Martin made a nice-ass huge breakfast for himself. He had a bagel, eggs, bacon, strawberries. He made a toast to himself. Cheers to the lone soldier. Oh, Kevin Martin. So then, I mean, he's been spending a lot of time by himself lately, but he did have a pretty genuine chat with Ika about how they're the last two vets standing. They're both super excited to partake in the BB Can Awards. They've always wanted to be a part of that, and it's such a big accomplishment for them to be a part of the Final Four. They really feel like this season was way more difficult than their first season, so they're really proud of it. I gotta say, this season was freaking nuts. It really was. But it's interesting. They brought up there's two vets left, one guy and one girl, and there's two newbies left, one guy and one girl, once they get rid of Dylan. So then they're talking about their games and, you know, just dissecting their different moves and their strategies. And Kevin's like, wow, Ika, your social game has been amazing, whereas mine has sucked. And she's just like, yeah. And again, they exchange the whole, if I don't win, I want you or Demetrius to win. They have like a mutual respect for each other on a game level. Great. Okay, so then there was more studying today. Lots and lots of studying. Imagine if the remaining competitions had nothing to do with what they're studying. That would be hilarious. I mean, really. But anyway, Dylan has not given up completely yet. He did ask Karen again, what's happening tomorrow? Is it going to be a 2-0 vote? What's the deal? And Karen's just like, I'm not going to let that Kevin Martin decide. Meaning, she's voting his ass out. It's going to be a 2-0. So Dylan's like, it's okay. I've made peace with it. I'm going to the jury house. He was all Casey Affleck in Manchester by the Sea. Okay. That's all right. So then Karen is like, seriously, if Kevin wanted Demetrius out, he would have put me up on the block and not you. And Karen has convinced herself that this is true. Oh my gosh. All right. So then Ika was there too for this discussion in the bathroom. And she's telling them, I swear to God, in everything I love, I am not working with Kevin, which is true. And Dylan's like, it's all good. There's nothing I can do or say at this point. I'm powerless. And he's going on to say, like, when he gets to that jury house, he is done with the game. He does not want to talk game with anyone. Good luck with that. All right. So tomorrow is the eviction. I think Dylan is actually planning on asking Ika for her vote. Good luck with that. But seriously, props for trying, because you gotta try everything, right? When your back's against the wall like that, you gotta try everything. So it'll be interesting to see if he actually does follow through and try that, and to see what Ika's response is. But anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comments, and until tomorrow, much love.